One, two, three strikes, you're out. Everyone knows that's a baseball analogy, but I'm willing to bet everybody here knows at least one person, one teacher, that doesn't give a kid a fourth strike. Now, I wonder how these metaphors get into education. And one of the things that we need to realize is that there are metaphors that we live by. There's metaphors whose perceptions and actions invade what we do without us even realizing that that's what's happening. And I think it's time for us to look at some of those metaphors. And one of the ones that I hate the most is the idea that education is broken. And education is transforming, not broken. Broken gives you the sense of repair, of remaking, of trying to fix, and it's just not a healthy model to focus on. Transforming is a beautiful word, and we need to think about transforming our language and our metaphors so that they're moving us in a positive and a wonderful direction. And as we look at transformation, we need to think about the fact that we need to embrace change. And if it's important enough, we will find a way. If it's not, we'll find an excuse. And if you look at this image, as long as something is important enough, we will make it change. But if it's too challenging, then we get lost and it doesn't happen. And I'll get back to this image in just a bit. But I want to look at some transformations and metaphors that I think we should be paying attention to. And the first one is we need to think about streams and not silos. One of the worst silos in education is the subject. We break things into math, English, social, and then we break the day up in order to look at those things individually. And what we really need to do is we need to look at streams, and we need to think of the big ideas and the big concepts and put them together and weave them together. Because if we think of a big theme, we can get students passionate about them and thinking about them and expanding their ideas. And when we look at streams, then we can start to realize that we can focus on different things and get the big concepts. At the Inquiry Hub, we're using design, stewardship, communication, and identity as places to focus those streams into one specific theme that students can then explore on their own and get excited about rather than just the subjects. Another idea to think about is scaffolding and not standardization. Standardization is too far overused in education right now, but we need to provide scaffolding and support for our students. Because the reality is that when we do things like inquiry learning, it's messy, and you can't standardize an inquiry process because the students are bouncing everywhere, and we need to scaffold and support them where they are in their learning, not in our plan that is scaffolded. Standardized. Thank you for your help. And if students lack resources, lack support, or lack reflection, then we're not providing that for them. A failure is just a failure. But if we are supporting them, then what actually happens is that even an epic failure can be an amazing learning experience on our journey rather than the destination. I'm tired of school being preparation for life. School is a journey, and it's an amazing experience, and we need to focus on that experience. Because learning is a verb. It is an action. It's about developing and inventing and creating things. And when students leave our schools, those things that they develop and construct are the things that they remember, not the subjects and not the final destination. Remember this image about embracing change? Everyone in here, that's not good enough to just embrace change. You are leaders and you need to inspire change. You need to increase the importance of change actually happening, reducing the challenge. And I believe that if we pay attention to the verbs, the language, if we think about the transformation of our metaphors and how we say things in education, then we are creating a more important opportunity for us to change. And if we don't, what we end up doing is we end up giving students a fourth strike. That's still stuck in the old metaphor, and that's not moving things along. Attention, we have lots of tools to give more attention in school, but that's not engagement. We need people to be engaged. Because teaching is not a business, teaching is a passion. And the passion that we have needs to be around learning. And we all need to be the lead learners, thinking about the language and the metaphors that we use. Because we are the leaders that need to think about, that lead the way for them. So what inspiring metaphors will you use is what I have as a question for you. Because whether you use the metaphors I've suggested or not, the thing is that you, me, we, will, if we transform our metaphors, if we transform our language, we will transform education. Thank you.
Thanks, bro.